Gentlemen's Star Parade with John Laurie, Harold Behrens, Cardi Robinson, the Springfields, Judith Chalmers, that's me, and of course, Ken Dodd. Oh!
It wasn't me, officer. It was Richard Dimbleby.
It's the Ken Dodd Show. Go away!
Oh, up there, Dan, Juan and Doris. Oh, hell, Bob. Never mind Barlow. Ken Dodd's on.
And you know, Ina, this pain I got when I tried to lift that motorbike upstairs.
That's it, that's the problem. That's
Well, ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I would like to say how highly honoured I am to have been chosen by the BBC to take part in this programme, which celebrates the 125th anniversary of the birth of Frankenstein.
Many happy turns of the day!
Pull that man's beard off and shove it down his ear hole. And here are just a few of the magnificent prizes that can be won here. A year's supply of fluff, one crippin set, a grandad cosy, a fur-lined thingy, a mechanical cabbage, a dwarf remover, and tonight's star prize, and an unmentionable object. Can we have the first contestant, please?
Aye.
Your name is?
We, John Ellery, much loved and respected Scottish actor of many years standing. Do you mind if I lean on you, son?
No, get off. And you have chosen to answer questions on?
European culture.
European culture, right. Listen to these three sounds. Now, which was it? A, B, or number six?
The one in the middle.
Correct. I'll give you a tuppence halfpenny and a broken bottle for the key.
I'll open yon box.
Are you sure?
I say I'll open yon box.
Very well, we'll open the box.
Oh, help, 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 help!
Pity. It was a lovely kilt, too. Now, here is the weather report for the eastern half of the country.
And scattered showers. With ground frost at night.
Well, what do you know?
Do you know that wives in Liechtenstein for years wore costume jewellery representing their family's entire wealth? And it wasn't unusual to see some women walking about wearing only a tuppence halfpenny stamp.
Well, what do you know?
Do you know that in Dundee it's considered unlucky to walk under a Scotsman's kilt?
Well, what do you know?
Here is a very unusual sound recording. That was hair growing. That was a man going bald. I don't know. What do we do next? Oh, I know. Gardeners, why not try turning the garden over this way? Prices for farmers. You should be able to get a good farmer for about 37 and 6 today. I wonder what people really do listen to on the radio. There's only one way to find out. I'll go out into the street and I'll ask them. Ah, here we are. Oxford Street Road. Now, I've got my microphone. Who shall I ask first? I'll ask this city gentleman in the pinstripe bowler. Excuse me, sir.
Those mints with a hole. I never touch the beastly things. Have a jelly, baby.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you, sir. Oh, here's a lady. Here's a lady just coming out of the hairdresser's. I'll ask her. Excuse me, madam.
Yes.
I wonder if you'd mind telling me the sort of programmes you listen to on the radio.
Certainly. Housewife's Choice, Woman's Hour, The Dales. I'm very fond of the radio. I hardly ever go out.
I'm not surprised. Thank you, madam.
My husband left me,
yes,
you know.
Yes, yes, well, thank you. Thank you very much, Bob.
Yes, yes, yes. Henry was a strange man. Left me to look after our little daughter. Didn't he, Naomi?
Yes, Mummy.
I'm sorry, madam, but you'll have to excuse me. I'm going to have a word with this little giddy old man over here. Good afternoon, sir.
I'm pleased to meet you, Wilfred.
No, I'm not Wilfred Pop.
I'm 89, Wilfred.
And you still want to have a go? Listen. Pop, I'm not Wilfred. You've got it wrong.
Have I got a song? Yes, Wilfred. Little Dolly Day.
No, okay,
dream,
Dad. Thanks, Dad. Yes, thanks. Okay, Dad. You won the 7 and 6.
Thank you very much. Cheerio, Ken.
You crafty old pensioner. There he goes, off for another spot of homely fun in some woman's house. He's a fellow selling newspapers. I'll ask him.
All the ladies of the shine, all the football reserves of paper.
Excuse me, which programmes do you like on the radio?
I'm fond of family favourites on a Sunday. Fond of family favourites on a Sunday.
How about any questions on a Friday? Any questions on a Friday?
Have you come here to be insulting? Have you come here to be insulting?
I only asked a civil question. I only asked a civil question.
Oh, Peter O'Clark, you're on the hero. Oh, Peter O'Clark, you're on the hero.
No, listen, no. Mr. Thompson, I'm from the BBC.
I see. Well, I can only let you have a tenner then, mate.
Oh, thank you very much. Who shall I ask next about what they like to hear on the radio? I know. I'll ask this window cleaner at the top of his ladder. I'll ask him. Hey, are you there?
You what?
I'm from the BBC.
You what?
I'm from the BBC.
You what?
I'm from the BBC.
You what?
And oh, blimey, if I had his address, I could write to him.
87 Halibut Terrace.
Clever fella, eh?
Don't shake that ladder.
You could hear me all the time, couldn't you?
Stop shaking that ladder.
Right in the canal.
I can't swim.
You what?
I can't swim.
You what?
I'm going under.
Which programme do you like to hear on the wireless?
Top of the Form and Listen with Mother.
Who's your favourite singing group?
The Springfields.
Do-it-yourself enthusiasts. This is your old friend, Andy Mann. Now, I'll not keep you a minute. I'm just boxing the wife in. Now, there we are. I'll let her out at tea time. Now, then, how did you go on with last week's job? A great many of you have written to me saying that I must have given the wrong instructions about the amount of timber needed for the job. Many of you couldn't get the pipe rack into the house. Well, I'm very sorry about that, because I forgot to mention that we weren't making a pipe rack, we were building a hen pen. Still, not to worry, it should prove very useful to those of you who keep hens that smoke. Now, this week we're going to make a serving hatch, and this little job shouldn't cost us any more than 15 shillings. We'll need 12 bags of cement, 50 bricks, and 100 weight of sand. Now, mix the cement in your old trousers. It's a bit uncomfortable, but the temperature is good for the cement. We'll also need about 3 pounds of 6-inch nails, or failing that, 6 pounds of 3-inch nails. Now, let's see what we've got in our little toolboxes. Or is it box eye? Yes. Let's see what's in the toolbox. I see. Yes. Nothing. The sides of the serving hatch will have to be wood-lined, and I suggest hickory. Hickory is your best bet every time, because it's a very reliable wood, is hickory. They use it a lot for making clocks. Anyway, that's what I'm going to use now. Well, what I'm doing here is I'm slotting A into the B section and making the joint good with a... with a B nail. If you've got dry rot, you'd best do this job sitting down. Yes. Now, it's coming along nicely. You see, on a job like this, good tools are half the battle. Half the battle, that's what good tools are. The battle's half over if you've got good tools, because they're half the battle. It's quite a simple job to put the head back onto the hammer. Having done that, we should find out that the glue is boiling nicely and almost ready. Now, I'll test it. Yes, it's perfect. Now, we've come now to the tricky part of the job, and that is knocking out the bricks from the wall to put in the serving hatch. Now, I'm only taking 25 bricks out of this job, you see. Here we are. Now, you see, it's quite simple. Barry Bucknell. Here we are. Just one more brick to come out, and here we go. I'll show you how to build a new house. It'll only cost about £5,000. First of all, we need half an acre of land, two lorries loaded...
Lovers will be delighted to hear that we have with us in the studio Mr. Kenneth Arthur Dodd, well-known music critic and distinguished conductor of the 75 bus. Mr. Dodd.
Jude, you thanketh. I mean, thank you, Judith. First, a roundup of news from the world of pop music, and a shock for fans. Flora Robson has left the Vernon's Girls. She told me in her dressing room at the Singlet Club last night, "I can't go on. I feel funny all over." The annual Screen Award for the Best Film Music of the Year has been won by Paddy Flaherty for his beautiful shillelagh theme from that wonderful Irish film Sodom and Begorra.
Now Maestro Dodd presents the all-time hit parade, the greatest songs in the world, songs that will live forever.
Yes, unforgettable songs like, what's he called?
Get a Move On, We Haven't Got All Flaming Night.
Oh, yes, lovely songs like Get a Move On, We Haven't Got All Flaming Night. I see what you mean, yes. Surely everyone remembers that delightful song written some years ago and called quite simply Till. Do you remember this next old favourite, Mistakes? Now we come to one of my own favourites, a very romantic song called A Kiss in the Dark.
Here, what's the game?
I'm sorry, officer. And this next one, an evergreen from Noel Card.
Oh, Look at that. Cool.
Of course, a room with a view.
Excuse me, Ken, can I interrupt? I know a song which I think will go into the all-time hit parade. I heard a fellow singing it on a record the other day. Do you know, I can't for the life of me remember his name for the moment. It says here. But the song was called Remember I Love You.
Remember I love you while you're far away. Remember I miss you each night and each day. Remember when strangers are charmed by your smile, that only a love that's true is really worthwhile. Remember when shadows are hiding the sun, but now and forever you're my wonderful one. Remember I love you till forever, my love. Remember when strangers are charmed by your smile, that only a love that's true is really worthwhile. Remember when shadows are hiding the sun, but now and forever you're my wonderful one. Remember I love you till forever, my love.
I suppose a lot of you listening to me now are thinking about your summer holidays. I'll bet the thousands of people, when they heard me in this show, said, let's go away somewhere. So, for anyone who hasn't made their mind up yet about where they're going, I've got a holiday guidebook here, and I'll read you some of the smashing places you can visit. I mean, how does this sound? 14 days coach tour of the Yorkshire Tyrol. How's that? 8 glorious days basking on the sun-drenched shores of the Costa Mersey. Pony trekking through the gently wooded slopes of Stepney, where one can pause and still see the age-old crafts being pursued, in spite of police warnings. Here's an unusual holiday, yachting on the M1. This is the time of the year when all the hotel keepers and boarding house people are getting ready for the holiday makers. They're all fixing their price lists and singing, let's twist again, like we did last summer. And a lot of people will be going to Wales this year, to places like Clan Flecky Nick Knock Knack Nick Nicky Knock Knack Nick Aberyth Ger Flecken Go Go Goch. The Isle of Man's a nice place. Oh, here's one. This sounds good up in Scotland. The Beacon Hotel. The Beacon Hotel. With a wonderful vista of the wild Scottish coastline. Well, that sounds good. Whilst at the Beacon Hotel, you will no doubt want to pay a visit. Turn over to our wonderful continental bar. There is dancing every night and a well-sprung settee in the games room. For further details, telephone Invercockie Leaky 22. General Manager, Mr. J. Lorry. By Jove, I like the sound of that. I'll give them a ring now. I'll ask the operator to get the number for me. They're very helpful these days. Hello, operator.
Hello, you dear subscriber. How do you do, you do? Is there some little number that I can get for you?
Yes, there is, Miss Callas. Have you got Invercockie Leaky 22?
How dare you?
No, it's in Scotland.
Oh. Hold the line, please. Go ahead, you're through now.
Hello, is that Invercockie Leaky?
No, this is Leaky Invercockie.
Oh, sorry. Hello, operator.
Hello, you dear subscriber.
Yes, right, thank you. Thank you, love, we've had that bit. Now, I wanted Invercockie Leaky, and you've given me Leaky Invercockie.
Oh, I'm so sorry, they all sound the same to me, you know.
No, they didn't. They're all invers and leakies and cockies and...
Go ahead.
Hello?
Oh, my bonny wee laddie. John Lorry speaking from the Beacon Hotel.
Oh, well, I didn't think it was the Edmundo Ross Club. Listen, Taffy, I'd like to stay at your hotel.
Certainly. What's the name, please?
The Beacon Hotel.
I know that one. What's your name?
Ken Dodd speaking.
Oh, aye. How do you spell that?
S-P-E-A-K-I-N-G speaking.
Hey, I see you have a sense of humour, man. You'll need it when you see this place.
Beg your pardon?
I said we'll need somebody like you in this place.
Oh.
How soon can he come?
Well, let me see. It's 11:30 here in the morning. That means it's 2:00 in the afternoon in Scotland. If I leave now, I should be there 30 minutes ago. How will that do you?
Oh, fine. It's a braw bricht min licht nicht nicht.
Pardon?
I said, it's a braw bricht min licht nicht nicht.
Oh, well, I'm not coming if it's foggy.
You'll be wanting full board.
Yes, please.
Right. I'll away and buy a bed.
Pardon?
I said, I'll go and buy some bread for your supper. It isn't for myself, you understand. I'll be waiting to meet you by the lock.
Which lock? Oh, no, never mind. I know the answer to that one. All right, I'll see you later.
I'm looking forward to meeting you, my bonny wee laddie.
I love that Bolton accent. Right, now then, how am I going to get there? That's the point. I know. I'll hop onto these two empty coconut shells and head for the border. Hi-ho, Silva! Hooray! Ah, here we are, right on the border. By Jove, this should be interesting. There's a man from the Scottish Tourist Board welcoming visitors to Scotland, and there's a man from the English Tourist Board welcoming visitors to England.
Welcome to Scotland with its breeze, locks and Robbie Burns.
Welcome to England with its Hamlets, taverns and Sheila Delaney.
Come to bonnie Scotland and see them tossing the caber.
Come to peaceful England and watch them coshing the wages, Clark.
Excuse me, can I come into Scotland?
Come along in, laddie. Come along in.
Right, well, hang on while I wipe my feet. I don't want to dirty your heather. Here, aren't you cold like that?
Oh, you mean my kilt?
Aye, put it on. So this is Scotland, is it? How much is it to come in?
Ah, bless you, laddie. Admission's free. You've been listening to too many tales about we Scots, you know.
I suppose I have, yeah.
Tell me, would you care to buy a raffle ticket?
Oh, it didn't take you long, did it? How much?
1 and 10 bob.
What's the first prize? 5 Robinson's hat. Ah, well, I'm on my holidays. Go on, I'll have one.
Where do you wish to go, laddie?
Invercockie Leaky.
What did you say?
Invercockie Leaky.
Don't you ever say that to me again, laddie.
Well, what have I said? Put me down.
Ah, look here, you. There's only one way to pacify me now. Buy the rest of these raffle tickets.
All right, I'll buy the rest of your flipping raffle tickets.
Ah, well, where are you going to, laddie?
I'm going to a place called Invercockie. Oh, no, never mind. I'll be skint before I get there. I'll find it myself. Hi-ho, Silver!
I see, buddy. I've got half of his holiday money here.
Hi. So this is Invercockie Leaky, is it? I wonder where the hotel is.
Good evening, sir.
Who?
We spoke this morning on the telephone. My name's Laurie, remember?
Oh, yes. You spoke to me all the way from Scotland. You must be one of those long-distance lorries.
Shall we go straight to the hotel, sir? It's on the other side of yon island. It's a beautiful little island. We We love it. We are not like rich city dwellers with our dreams of riches and personal gain caught up in an everlasting battle of greed and lust for money, no. We are richer than most.
Oh, I feel awful now, you know what I mean? You know, I mean, money doesn't mean a thing when you put it like that, does it? Is there any ferry?
Well, old Jock will row us across. A kindly old man of these parts who's been rowing folk to the island for many, many years.
Where is he now?
Who?
Old Jock.
Good evening, sir.
You?
I step into the boat. That'll be 5 bob, please.
5 bob? I thought you were supposed to be one of those simple people.
It isn't for myself. You understand.
Oh, so that's the Holiday Island, is it?
The what? Oh, aye, the Holiday Island, yes, that's it.
What's it called?
Dead Man's Rock.
Dead Man's Rock? It sounds like a new dance. Oh, I've changed my mind. I'll go to Blackpool instead.
Wait until I get into Hangman's Creek. You'll be able to see the hotel. It's got illuminations just like Blackpool, man. There it is.
Is that it? I'll say it's got illuminations. It's a flaming lighthouse.
Come along now. Step ashore.
Listen, if you think I'm going to spend a holiday with you locked up in that seagull's lamppost, you've got another thing coming. I'm going back home.
Oh, dear me, Luke. The boat has drifted away.
You let go of the rope.
For your own good. The sea's very rough now. It isn't for myself. You understand.
Now listen here, Barnacle Butlin.
Welcome to the Beacon Hotel. Step inside. Here we are. And I hope you enjoy your holiday.
Oh, I'm sure I will. I'll be able to send some smashing postcards home from here. Dear Auntie Nellie, having a wonderful time. I've been trimming the wick all week. Where's this never-ending round of fun and games I read about in the guidebook?
The what? Oh, aye, plenty of fun and games. Just a minute now. Now, which hand is the button in?
Which hand is the button in? What about the dancing twice nightly?
Ha! Just a moment. May I?
Of course. It's a lovely band.
Do you come here often?
Only when I'm out of my mind. Let go! Listen, I want a drink.
Oh, at the Continental Bar.
Oh, this should be good. Where's the Continental Bar?
Right behind you.
What, that? A bottle of brown ale standing next to a photo of De Gaulle?
Well, what do you expect? What do you expect for 5.5 guineas all in?
You'll get no 5.5 guineas off me. I won't be here for a week.
A week? It's 5.5 guineas a day. We have a very complicated defence plan to pay for, you know. It isn't for myself.
You understand. I understand. But listen... Let's have that bottle of brown ale.
Certainly, here you are. That'll be 1 and 6, please.
I've only got 1 and 4.
You owe me tuppence, then.
That's it. That's the one that did it right. Well, I'm off. I'm going back to England.
Hey, there's no boat.
I'll swim for it.
You'll get soaked.
I've been getting soaked ever since I came here. Cheerio!
It wasn't for myself. You understand?
Welcome to Bonnie Scotland with its locks, braes, glens.
Yeah, I can wrap that lot up. Listen, come on, open the door. I'm going back to England.
Oh, just a minute, sir, just a minute. Have you got a raffle ticket number 868?
Let me see. Yes, I have.
Why, laddie, this is great. You won the first prize. Congratulations.
First prize? Well, Joe, it's about time I had a bit of luck.
Yes, you're a very lucky man. You have won a 3-week holiday at the Beacon Hotel. Yes, and the manager here is personally waiting in his car.
Aye, laddie, climb in and we'll away.
No, I couldn't stand 3 more weeks of you.
Get in the car.
No, listen, no, I want to go back to England. No, help.
It isn't for myself, you understand.
Featured Ken Dodd. Appearing with him were John Lorry, Cardew Robinson, Harold Behrens, the Springfields, and Judith Chalmers. The script was written by Eddie Brabourne and Ken Dodd, and the BBC Review Orchestra was conducted by Malcolm Lockyer. The Ken Dodd Show was produced by Eric Miller.